Since its departure on 5th of September 1977, Voyager 1 has been helping us learn more about the outer solar system and interstellar space, a region of space that is billions and billions of miles away from our little planet. Incredibly, it appears that Voyager 1 is finding its way back home. How is this possible, and what are the implications of its return towards the future of space exploration? In order to understand how massive this event is, it is important to know how groundbreaking Voyager 1's findings were. It surpassed expectations by becoming the first man-made object to leave our solar system as it entered into a region known as interstellar space. This also makes it the only man-made thing that has ever covered such a distance. The brilliance of this probe didn't stop there, as it thrust itself through space so rapidly that it beat Voyager 2, its twin probe, to Jupiter, even though it was launched 2 weeks after Voyager 2. As rapid as it was also detailed with its coverage of the solar system because it remitted images to Earth that was simply so amazing. It is still being used by schools and media outlets worldwide. Within these detailed images, Voyager I shocked everyone when it revealed a thin ring around the planet while also exposing two moons, Thebes and Metis. It also revealed that Jupiter's moons were active worlds, if you can believe it, with moons such as Europa, where it is believed that there are subsurface oceans of water. Voyager. I was able to make this amazing journey thanks to a fortunate alignment of the outer planets that only occurs once every 176 years. Thanks to this, both Voyager 1 and the second were able to maximize the power emitted from three radioisotope thermoelectric generators as they jumped from planet to planet. Upon realizing that the probes may be able to travel beyond our solar system, NASA made sure both ships carried special disks known as the Golden Records. Acting as a record of everything that makes our planet so special, the Golden Record contained everything ranging from whale calls to music to greetings in about 52 languages. Even more importantly, it let the galaxy know where we are, as the Golden Records also contained the location of our sun. Along with the Golden Record, Voyager 1 was also fitted with 10 scientific instruments, such as a two-camera imaging system, multiple spectrometers, a magnetometer, and detectors for low-energy charged particles and high-energy cosmic rays. Everything on this probe seems to aid in improving our knowledge of space, because even its communication system has helped mission team members to learn more about planets and their moons. Soon, the spacecraft completed its mission by remitting images of Jupiter and Saturn. After providing more details about the gigantic planet, Voyager 1 made its way past Pluto as it approached interstellar space. However, before it did this, the probe captured one of the most iconic images ever when it took a picture of our home on 14th of February 1990. This was done when it was about 3.7 billion miles away, as this must have been quite the vantage point for the spacecraft. While it was there, it also took many pictures of other celestial beings in our solar system, such as Venus, Jupiter, Neptune, and the Sun. As you look into these images and identify the pale blue dot as our home, you come to realize how small we all are as we float along this tiny pebble in a vast universe. After taking these photos, the probe finally made its way through the heliosphere, the giant layer of charged particles that the Sun blows around itself, in 2012. This was only discovered after the probe's plasma wave instrument recorded a powerful solar eruption at some point in time between April 9th and May 22, 2013. After determining that the official date of Voyager 1's departure from the solar system was August 25, 2012, the same day that famed astronaut Neil Armstrong died, it was recorded that the spacecraft was officially 11.25 billion miles, or 121 AU, away from the Sun. And as it entered the next phase of its journeys, it took notice of the wonders that lay beyond our solar system. Among the amazing phenomena it recorded, the probe was able to give us detailed information about how charged particles from the Sun interact with other particles that are emitted by other stars. Following this, it is estimated that in about 40,000 years, Voyager shall make its next major milestone as it travels within 1.7 light-years of AC plus 79388, a star that is about 17.5 light-years away from Earth. Considering the fact that the spacecraft is supposed to be billions of miles away and will continue to go further for thousands of years, it is important that its deep space network continues to function properly. DSN is a collection of big radio antennas that are distributed all over the planet and is the only thing that keeps us in contact with the probe. Amazingly, this gives NASA the ability to send and receive signals to the probe within 20 hours of their emission. In order to receive these signals, the probe is fitted with 23-watt radios. These are low-power transmitters that are 7 times more powerful than the transmitters found in your iPhone. Along with the massive 3.7-meter antenna that is fixed on the probe, it has been smooth sailing when it comes to using the DSN to transmit the secrets of the universe beyond our solar system. So if Voyager 1 is continuously traveling away, how is it that it's returning to the Earth? Well, that might be because for a few months each year, the distance between the Earth and the probe. This is because during those months, the Earth's orbit moves closer to the spacecraft before retreating. This is possible because the Earth's orbit around the Sun is faster than the Voyager spacecraft. For those that don't know, the Earth travels at a speed of 67,000 miles per hour. In contrast, the Voyager can reach speeds of 38,210 miles per hour, which makes it faster than Voyager 2, which can only travel at speeds of about 35,000 miles per hour. As such, during those months when the Earth seems closer to the probe than ever, that is because during that time, the Earth speeds towards the probe at a rate that is too fast for the spacecraft to get away. However, the long-term future of Voyager 1 and Voyager 2, which also experiences this annual loop closer to the Earth, is that they will eventually depart from the solar system when it travels through the old cloud, a shell of comets and rubble that orbits around the Sun at a distance of 100,000 AU. Which is 100,000 times the distance between the Earth and the Sun. At that point, the probe will be drawn to other stars outside our solar system, and the Sun will be too weak to prevent it from approaching an alien star. Within 30,000 years, the first of such stars will be a red dwarf star, known as Ross 248. Seeing as the Voyager is going to spend eternity in the galaxies, especially as it is believed that it will still be around when our solar system has orbited our galaxy in the following 500 million years, we wonder whether the golden records will still be intact if and when any other sentient beings find it. Well, it is believed that the records have been designed to last for many years, maybe even up to a billion years if you can believe it. This is because of the all-around protection given to the novel item. Just underneath the gold casing is an aluminum sheet that protects the copper core. Nonetheless, it is still believed that there might be some harsh elements in the universe that might damage the records. Dust clouds and particles from the top planes of the galaxy where the probe tends to linger are proving to be the most harmful of the lot. It is also believed that the particles within these massive clouds may have enough gravitational pull to detract the probe from its trajectory. Nonetheless, it is believed that since the engraved signs are tucked away from the spacecraft's body, there is a high chance that the golden record will remain intact and legible as it travels through the universe. Based on the trajectory of the future of the universe, it seems to be that Voyager may be around, at least partially, for up to a period of 5 billion years. That is, if it survives the collision of the Milky Way galaxy and the Andromeda galaxy. If both Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 can survive this experience, they may travel to regions unknown, recording and observing stars and planets that may not even be in existence today. Do you want to know more about our universe? Why don't you like and subscribe so you can gain access to more content like this one? In conclusion, although Voyager I may not be coming back home now or ever, we hope that it can help us learn even more about the universe than it already has. Maybe one day it can educate another civilization out there too. Maybe one day they will bring it back home. That's it for this video. Feel free to explore our previous videos to get your mind blown. Until next time, goodbye.